So the big thing that I want to point out about the Kaplan prep course is that, and so I was actually a little bit scared to not use Kaplan, you're going to be doing it by yourself. Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, please subscribe so that you guys don't miss out on any more great content. And please hit that like button because honestly, it just helps me out. And when you hit that like button or subscribe, those numbers go into YouTube's algorithm and it just helps me rank higher on the search results. And that's just the blunt truth of it. And so today's video, as you guys can see, is just gonna be a quick review on the Kaplan MCAT prep course. And so when I was gonna start studying for the MCAT, I was asking around what people recommended that I used in order to do well on the exam. And a lot of people mentioned Kaplan because Kaplan is just a big brand that everybody knows. And so I was actually a little bit scared to not use Kaplan. And so if everyone else is using Kaplan, I didn't want to be on like a different playing field. So I just did what everybody else did and I purchased the Kaplan prep course. And I did the prep course that was in person. You had an instructor. The instructor usually did really well on the MCAT and was also usually applying for medical school. And in my case, my instructor did like 95th percentile or something close to that. And he was currently applying to medical school as well. And actually the funny thing was, is that he got his acceptance letter about halfway through teaching our course. And even though he did really well on the MCAT, he was only accepted into a DO school. And so I plan on making a video comparing MD and DO schools. But for those of you that are just now applying, don't let that bother you. Just apply to both of them because they are very similar. And also just a quick side note, both MD and DO residency programs are gonna merge in 2020. So if that's what's stopping you from applying DO versus MD, just throw that thought out the window and double your chances by applying to both of them. So for those of you who have actually taken the Kaplan course, I'm sure some of you actually really enjoyed the course. But for me, it just wasn't what I needed. Not to mention the course was like $2,000 or $3,000. Basically what we did in the prep course is we met 2 or 3 times a week for about 4 hours each time. And all we did was go through Kaplan's workbook and we did practice problems. The instructor taught us some decent strategies on test taking. He explained why certain answers were correct versus incorrect. If like the majority of us got it incorrect, of course. And so it was kind of like going to a normal college class where you sit through like a lecture, you take notes, you do some practice problems, and that was about it. So the big thing that I want to point out about the Kaplan prep course is that the bulk of the information and content that you will be learning is going to be at home. You're going to be doing it by yourself. Now, I don't know about you guys, but personally, if I'm gonna pay someone $2,000 or $3,000 to help me do well on an exam, then I want them to cater to my specific needs. And since I was so new to applying to medical school and taking the MCAT, I didn't really know how to study for such a big exam because there's so much content that we need to know. And Kaplan just did not focus on the individual person. One great thing about Kaplan is their books. Now, if you haven't purchased books yet, I would go with the Kaplan books because they're really straight to the point. You're not gonna learn excess material that's not even on the MCAT. And the Kaplan books actually have really good explanations and practice problems. And so going back to the Kaplan course, the majority of our coursework was done at home. And a lot of that coursework was actually watching videos and reading the books. Now, I think it's kind of ridiculous that I paid about $3,000 for this course only to have someone tell me to read the books and to watch YouTube videos. So guys, I actually recently just found a smaller prep company called MCATselfprep.com. And this prep company is just starting. They're fairly small, but they actually cater to the individual's needs. And so my recommendation is to check out this company because the bulk of their content is free. They do the exact same thing as Kaplan, only you're not paying $2,000 or $3,000. You're paying a maximum of like $100 if you want to buy their set of flashcards that are already made. And these flashcards are actually really great because they complement the videos that you're watching. And these videos are on YouTube. They come from Khan Academy and other video sites. And all this company did was take Khan Academy's videos and organize them into the sections of the MCAT. They also recommend getting a set of textbooks. So whether it's Khan Academy or Princeton Review, my personal preference would be to just get the Kaplan books because I think they're pretty good. And you can get them on Amazon for pretty cheap. And then all you do is watch the videos, you read the passages in the books that this company instructs you to do, and then you just have a well-organized study plan. So I guess, guys, the moral of the story is don't be frightened by doing something different. Don't think that by paying $3,000 for a test prep company is gonna get you the 95th percentile. Because most of those videos that you're watching on YouTube about how to get the 100th percentile or 95th percentile are honestly just not gonna work for the majority of people. Because those students that are making those videos probably got a 4.0 in their undergrad. And so they were already smart and well prepared for the MCAT. Now for the majority of people, we're gonna get around a 500 to a 510, and that's just the reality of it. So I hope I'm not offending anybody, but this is just a non-BS YouTube channel, and this is just something that everybody just needs to know. Now, I'm not saying you can't get in the 95th percentile, it's just very unlikely because the average on the MCAT is a 500. So my recommendation is to check out that website, mymcatprep.com. Use their videos, which are on YouTube. They just organize them. Get a set of books. Just get Kaplan's books if you don't know which ones. And also on mcatprep.com, I would recommend purchasing their flashcards. And they use the platform Quizlet. And as you go through the videos that are on their website, you're gonna go through the Quizlet flashcards that they have already made, and those flashcards are gonna reinforce your knowledge of the video content. So trust me guys, you are not missing out on anything that Kaplan has to offer or any of these other giant test prep companies. And guys, if you're liking the advice that I'm giving right now, we do have a Facebook group and page called Med School Mentor. And it's a group where students can collaborate with each other about questions they have about the application process or how to study for the MCAT. And if you go on our page, you can actually shoot me a message and we can get in contact and I can actually help you with any other questions that you may have. So guys, I really hope this video helped you out and also saved you a bit of money. And so if you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please check out my other YouTube videos on how to study for the MCAT, on how to pick medical schools, some secrets that med schools don't really want us to know, and some other great topics. And if you want to keep seeing great content like this, hit that subscribe button. And guys, I'll see you in the next video.